Hey guys, so I am here to do me and Olivia's 1 year breastfeeding update. Yes, we did make it to a whole year of breastfeeding and I am so happy and I feel so like proud of myself and proud of Olivia. And I always kind of knew we would make it because of how much we had been through. I just kind of knew like after all that we had been through, there was just like no stopping us at some point. So yeah, I'm really, really happy that we made it to 1 year and we are still going strong on breastfeeding for sure. Of course, there is some changes now, which I will get into what it's like breastfeeding a 1 year old and kind of a toddler already. But first, I want to kind of take off from where we left off with 6 months because there was a few things that did happen that didn't get mentioned. They got mentioned in other videos, but not in a full breastfeeding update. So after Olivia turned 6 months, I had my cycles back pretty much full throttle and I did start noticing kind of a slow letdown, and also Olivia did fall off of her growth curve. So that was really like, I think the biggest, maybe not the biggest, but another big stress and thing we had to get through. And how we did it, maybe I will make a whole video on how I brought my milk supply up, but I basically started taking fenugreek herbs, drinking loads of water, drinking loads of teas, cluster feeding her, offering her the boob constantly, and especially during my period time. My milk supply would seem basically really good when I wasn't on my period. Basically, whenever I was PMSing, and when I would get my period, I would notice a really slow letdown and maybe a slight decrease in supply. So during those times, I had to, you know, really drink a lot of extra water and feed her a lot more frequently. Like we're talking every half an hour to an hour is how often I would feed her. I also learned with Olivia, she just does better with more frequent feeds because this really helped ensure that she would get the caloric milk. She just needed to eat very frequently because she has such a fast metabolism. All babies are different, and Olivia just definitely was one that needed to be fed very, very frequently, and I just kind of had to deal with that. I was basically feeding her, you know, a lot for her age range, which was a huge sacrifice, but is all completely worth it. I'm really glad that we made it through that hump. And then around 9 or 10 months, I started noticing that, you know, we were able to feed her a little bit more solids. She was eating a little bit more like purees and stuff, and also, you know, self-feeding herself with baby-led weaning. And I started noticing actually that I wasn't having a slow letdown during my periods anymore. I feel like my body sort of adapted to menstruating and breastfeeding at the same time, which is quite a juggling act because all of the hormones are like so different and so crazy. I started noticing during my period that everything was fine. There wouldn't be any slow letdown or any decrease in supply. So my body just adapted, which was really great. So I'm happy to say like the last 3 months of breastfeeding have definitely improved for sure. Like she doesn't have to feed as much. Like she was feeding at that time, she was every 2 to 3 hours, which was awesome because my body got used to doing it, which was great. Plus she was on a little bit of solids. And then now how things are going is she is breastfeeding every 3 hours at the moment. It's been going on for about a week, but I think it's more of a psychological thing. I think she's going through some psychological changes and she just wants to nurse more. She's like comfort nursing a lot. And she was, at 11 months, she was able to go 4 to 5 hours without nursing, but now it's every 3 hours pretty much. She just really needs to nurse at the moment a lot. And I have no problem with nursing her to whatever she wants, you know, like I don't really know. I think we're gonna do, you know, just let her lead the way when it comes to when she wants to stop. I'm hoping it's not like freakishly long, but I'm okay with it. And I would actually love to nurse her to the age of 2. According to the World Health Organization, that is what's recommended. Anyways, so I would breastfeed her till 2 years old if that's what she wants, but I don't really hold any high expectations for that like I did for 1 year. So I'm just kind of okay with whenever she's done, she's done. I feel comfortable with that. And so the plan is to just let her self-wean, and until then, I will just continue to breastfeed her on demand. So, all right, that is our whole 1 year breastfeeding update. I feel so grateful that we made it this far after all that we've been through. It was not an easy journey. It was not as natural of a process as I thought it was gonna be. I really hope things go better next time, and there will be some things that I will do differently next time with our second baby to ensure that maybe things go a little bit more smoothly than it did with Olivia. But overall, I'm really, really grateful for our story and our journey, and I feel like I've learned so much, and yeah, I'm just so happy. All right, so I'm gonna go and I'll talk to you guys really soon.